are over. And life is like a song.
Oh. Hi, folks, and thank you for watching By the Book, a show based on recipes that we find in cookbooks, magazines, and on the internet, and then we share that information with you, the viewer, so you can have that for your own personal recipe library. Today, we're going to be doing two separate recipes for you. Guys, this is focused on you. Two simple recipes, good for the Valentine's Day and impress the ladies. Our first recipe is going to be jambalaya. It's an easy one-pot recipe that's going to be sure to impress the ladies. And then our second recipe is going to be the raspberry trifle, which is a trifle. Our second recipe is going to be a raspberry trifle, which is going to consist of only four ingredients. Let's get cooking. Our ingredients for the jambalaya start with one large chopped onion, one medium bell pepper chopped, two stalks of celery chopped, three cloves of garlic finely chopped, got half a teaspoon of dried thyme, half a teaspoon of parsley flakes, half a teaspoon of salt, and then another half a teaspoon of pepper. And then we also got two cups of smoked sausage here, chopped, and also have 1 pound of shrimp, cleaned and deveined, and then finally a 28-ounce can of diced tomatoes. Let's begin cooking. First, we start off, we want to brown our sausage just a little bit. Now, I've got a cast iron Dutch oven here, so I've had it preheating just a little bit right now. So you want to go ahead and put your sausage in that and let it begin to brown. Now that we've browned our sausage, we're just going to toss in all the remaining ingredients, except the shrimp, vegetables, plus all the dry ingredients, and this is the onions and the garlic. I'm going to set those in there. I'm going to still let those vegetables sweat up on the same medium-high heat as we did on the sausage. Now that our vegetables are all sweated down, we add in our tomatoes. And finally, to kick it up, about a quarter of a teaspoon of the good stuff. I can't say the name, they didn't give us any endorsements, but I'd let you know, I put that stuff on everything. Mix it up all together real well. Turn your heat down to medium. Cover it Let it go 35, 40, 45 minutes, and then also make 4 cups of white rice with that. Now on to our dessert. Now for the dessert, the raspberry trifle is a family-sized dessert, so you'll be able to make it in a bowl like this. But since it's good for, since it's the Valentine's Day right now, we're going to be doing, personally, little glasses like this. You can find glasses like this in your bargain store. Nothing really too fancy, but it looks fantastic. So let's start putting it all together. Here I've got 2 8-ounce packages of cream cheese. I almost forgot what I had. I've got 2 tablespoons of lemon juice. Add that in there. I got 1.5 teaspoons of vanilla plus 1/2 cup of sugar. Now we're going to take all these ingredients and we're going to beat them together with a mixer. Make sure that your cream cheese is room temperature and not out of the refrigerator, otherwise it'll be very hard to whip. Finally, we're going to put in our whipped cream. Now with our whipped cream, you can use the mixer or you can use a spatula and fold it in. I really don't see the big difference, so I'm just going to toss it all in there. And after you empty the whipped cream, you have a nice salad bowl.
To whip it! Whip it good!
Now that I've got all that whipped together, we're going to start building our dessert. I've got here some prepared pound cake, or you can use angel food cake. I've cut this about the width of my pinky. We're going to take our cup, and we're going to build this. So, take the cake, break them in half, start at the bottom. And then we're going to take some, did I mention the raspberries? I didn't mention the raspberries. I'm a dork. We're going to need 1 8-ounce package of frozen raspberries plus 1 package of fresh raspberries. And then when you're thawing out the raspberries, put them in a colander over a measuring cup like this and grab all the reserved juice. You're going to need this. So we put the cake inside the cup like that. Then we're going to take some of this reserved juice that we got from the frozen. Just kind of drizzle it down the side here. A couple drops in the middle there. Then we're going to take some of our now thawed out raspberries. Put a couple of those inside. Not too much. You don't want to overcrowd this dessert. You want to let all the flavors of the pound cake also come out in this. Then we're going to take our mixture that we incorporated here with the cream cheese, and we're just going to dabble some right inside. Okay, then we're going to repeat the process again. Put some more cake, a little bit more of that juice we got from the raspberries when we thawed them out, some more of the frozen raspberries, and then once again with the mixture that we did. This time I'm going to use a spoon. You want to kind of get it down in there and let some of the cream cheese mixture hit the glass so it shows itself. One more time, we'll just repeat the process all over again. Bread, juice, raspberry, fish, filling. When you get close to the top, you want to put a big dollop of that filling right on top there, because that is going to be the top part of the presentation of this dessert. Then you want to take your fresh raspberries, put a few of them on top. A nice display. You can go around the glass, or you can go in the middle of the glass, kind of tuck them down in there. This is a very nice, very easy dessert. It's fresh, it's tart, and it's sure to delight the taste buds. So there you go. Raspberry trifle. 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 I'm going to call it a trifle. I don't care what you like. Nah. Yummy, yummy, yum, yummy. Two raspberry trifles done. What you want to do is you want to put them in the refrigerator and chill them down just before having them. Now it's time to check our jambalaya. Got a nice simmer on it. Everything's nice and hot in here. It's reduced down a little bit. Our tomatoes are cooked now all the way through. And the final step now is to add their 1 pound of shrimp. Mix all those in there thoroughly. Put the lid back on it, cook it for another 5 to 10 minutes or until the shrimps are cooked all the way through. Now that our rice is done and our jambalaya is finished, put a nice, good spoonful size of rice here in the middle. We'll take some of our jambalaya. Put it right there in the center of that. You see all the shrimp, all that nice rustic tasting flavor of the jambalaya here. Well, I hope you enjoyed the show. Don't forget to leave your questions and comments, and we'll be posting the internet site where we found these two recipes at. Thanks for watching. God bless you, and have a good night.